Hi again, and I'm going to do one more video this evening, and this video is for the folks who are interested in time management. Court reporters are dealing with deadlines day in, day out, and we need to be able to manage them, to manage our life, our priorities, our health, our sleep, and it's really important that we don't go too far to one end or the other. I don't consider myself an expert. Everything for me has been trial and error. I have found some things that really work for me. I do not have any set schedule. I'm a true freelancer. Sometimes I scope, sometimes I report, sometimes I teach. It's just a combination of a lot of things. So my first go-to item is Google Calendar. Google Calendar for me, because I use Gmail and because I have a Samsung phone, Google Calendar for me is my default. I love Google Calendar mostly because it's easy to use and it is color codable and I can share it with folks. So I can share my reporting schedule with my scopist or my proofreader. If they need to know when I am out on a job, they'll be able to see. Because I'm working, they'll be able to see what's coming down the pike. I can share my convention schedule with folks. I can pretty much share any one I want with various people. I can color code them. So for myself, I'm a visual person. I need to know when things are due. So I color code deadlines in red. I color code scoping assignments when I'm actually working for someone else as a scopist. I color code them as pink. I color code reporting as orange, and then I have other things like exercise is green and professional meetings is gray, travel is yellow. So I can visualize my calendar very easily. And then what I do for my deadlines is I also on each deadline will say remind me in one day prior, so that I can just get a flashing little note or an email when I come up to my computer that says, you have an event in one day. One of the court reporters that I trained as a baby reporter, she was working on the 8-day deadlines. Her firms were asking for her 8-day turn. So what she would do as a new reporter, she wasn't taking that many days, but she would take a deposition and then 7 days out, she would schedule herself off for that day, just in case she hadn't gotten her transcripts done. Now, I'm not sure how well that would work in the long term, because the idea would be to continue to get more work and you'd end up scheduling yourself off half the time. But for her, as a beginner, I thought it was a really good idea. I also use a whiteboard. I like to be able to visualize at my desk rather than flipping back and forth what's upcoming. So I have a 5-week whiteboard right above my, it's literally right above my desk. And I can look at it and say, okay, well, I will be teaching at the North Carolina State meeting on Monday, June 20 and 21st. And I've got that blocked off in red, again, with my colors. And then I have a personal meeting on the 23rd. I'm going to go look at a kayak, so I did that in blue. Again, it's just more reminders of what things are going to do. I have one of the girls that I have mentored is a paper calendar person. She has a little open calendar, and she uses colored pens. And she does basically the same thing I do with my Google Calendar, but she just does it on a piece of paper in a bound calendar. And I'm sure there are many other things to do time management wise for at least deadlines. If we get to the daily time management, there are other things that you can do. I like to put on my calendar when I'm actually going to go to gym. So if I know that I'm going to be scoping on a Tuesday, say, for example, I know this. Don't have a deposition on there. I know that my spin class is at 6, so I will schedule to go to the gym. And I actually put that on my calendar. So it's like an assignment for myself. It just happens to be an exercise assignment rather than a work assignment. I find that if I schedule myself to be someplace, I'm much more likely to be there than if I say, well, I'll see how I feel on Tuesday afternoon. And if I want to go to the gym, I will. And if not, this way it's on my calendar and I've kind of committed to it. let's see, what else? Daily, when you're scoping, one of the things that I find is that I get totally engrossed when I'm scoping and sitting at the computer. And of course, sitting is really bad. I heard someone say sitting is the new smoking. I don't know if I go that far. But what I do notice is that when you sit a lot, you tend to not get your blood flowing, and so your feet might get a little swollen, or your butt or your low back may start to hurt. So there are a couple things that you can do. One of my favorite little things is a little kitchen timer. I have a little kitchen timer. I'm a cat person. It's an orange cat. And you can set a little kitchen timer and just set it for, you know, for 30 minutes. And then when the timer goes off, you get up and you walk around, maybe go down the stairs, do the laundry, come back up, and then set it again. There's another online program that you can do. It's called Pomodoro, like Italian for tomato, Pomodoro. And the way it's done is you can set the timer, and for 25 minutes you just work, and then the timer goes off, and for 5 minutes you can get up and do whatever you want, and then it'll do another 25 minutes, and another 5, 25, 5, 25, 5, and then you get a 15-minute break. So you could do that if you really have a lot of pages that you have to get done and you really need to focus and not go on Facebook. Of course, everyone has a smartphone these days. Everyone's got a timer on there. You could certainly do that as well. And I think that's pretty much it for time management. I'll get to job management perhaps in another video, talk about how to organize your work. But anyway, baby steps, everybody. Time management is a skill that you never master, I don't think. I think it's just you get there for a while and then all of a sudden you fall back into old habits, but it's okay. You can get right back on. Use Google Calendar, some other calendaring function, use a timer, and just make sure to get up and move, because the bottom line is we don't want to grow our bottoms. Anyway, thanks.